Welcome to our service of Holy Communion, Parish Communion, Harvest Festival Holy Communion. Because today is our Harvest Festival. And if you have any harvest gifts, we try to head off people bringing up harvest gifts because there are some issues about people moving about too much. But if you have any, there'll be a point at what would normally be the offer. Tell you when to bring them on. The other thing to tell you is the church annual parochial church meeting and vestry meeting for the election of church wardens will take place on Sunday the 25th of October, immediately following the parish communion service. However, you're not all going to be around here for ages. To keep it quick, we're only actually having elections. All the reports are online. Some of them are in my report, the electoral roll report, and the accounts are all in either last month or this month's magazine. And other reports will be available at the back of the church for you to read as well before the meeting. So we're not having reports. And if having read them, you've got a question, send the question in to me in advance, I try and get an answer, because we're not taking questions for the meeting either. Not that we often get a lot of questions, but we could show will it shall. So that's the annual parochial church meeting and election of church wardens, 25th of October, immediately following the parish communion. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all
reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. The point is this: the one who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and the one who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance, so that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. He who supplies the seed of the sower and bread for the food will multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way for your great generosity, which will produce thanksgiving to God through us. For the rendering of this ministry not only supplies the needs of saints, but also overflows with many thanksgivings to God. Through the testing of this ministry, you glorify God by your obedience and the confession of the gospel of Christ, and by the generosity of your sharing with them and with all others, while he has given you. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. This is the word of the Lord.
We stand to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Then he told them a parable. The land of a rich man produced abundantly, and he thought to himself, "What should I do? For I have no place to store my crops." Then he said, "I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, 'Soul, you have ample goods, laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this very night your life is being demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, whose will they be?' So it is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but are not rich towards God." He said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the fields, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all these things, and your Father knows that you need them." This is the gospel of the Lord.
May the words of my lips, thoughts of all our hearts, be now ever acceptable in your sight. Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Amen. As I said a few moments ago, our harvest festival coincides with the feast France of Assisi, and it seems really very appropriate, because Because Francis' great message, despite all the stories about preaching to birds and taming wolves and things, it isn't. His fundamental message isn't about living in harmony with nature. To be honest, most medieval saints seem to get on quite well with wild animals. It happens again and again. It's one of these recurrent themes. But the central part of Francis' message is giving of things away. Giving away your possessions. He famously, seeking, having nothing else to give because his father had stopped his allowance, gave away all his clothes to a beggar in the street, and the bishop had to wrap him up in a cloak to get him back inside without scandalizing people too much. Francis didn't really think we ought to bother about having our own property. Should just give things away as they arrive and rely on God to give us what we need. Just, in fact, as Jesus says in today's gospel, which is set both for harvest and for the feast of St. Francis. Don't keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all these things. Francis taught that God loves us, that we should trust in his love, that we should trust that he'll provide for us, and we should show the same loving care to others. He echoed Jesus' words about giving all you have to the poor. In the end, the church agreed that, as Jesus said, your Father knows you need a certain number of possessions, but said that we shouldn't be too attached to them, and we should always be ready to share the good things we have. But the arguments between the church authorities who taught this and Francis' followers who wanted to keep on with this rejection of possessions, well, that went on for years. If any of you have ever read the book, The Name of the Rose, or seen the film, that's actually the argument that's going on behind. It's called the Apostolic Poverty Controversy. I knew one day I'd get a chance to bring it into a sermon. Anyway, at the very least, though, the message of Francis, today, and indeed every day, is that part of being thankful to God for God's gifts to us in the harvest, part of being thankful for the way God provides us with abundance of food, abundance of all sorts of good things, is to be willing to share that abundance with others, to be generous in giving to those who need. When it comes to a choice between giving to those in need and wanting to make sure we're safe and secure and have plenty ourselves, well, Francis would say that's not really a choice at all. After all, don't we trust God to look after us? So, though bringing up harvest gifts to go to the food bank or the women's refuge, that's a good thing. We should also give to the bishop's harvest appeal or Christian aid or whatever as well. We should give what we can. We show thanks for what we are given by giving in our turn. Just as we show thanks for God's forgiveness by forgiving others. And we show thanks for God's love by loving others. Francis does have an environmental message for us as well. Francis saw our existence on earth as depending on a whole range of elements, not just chances of a planet having everything they need, just like this one, just coming about, that's millions to one. Francis said, well, it's fairly obvious, isn't it? God made it. God provided it for us. So Francis, just he calls us to love others because God loves us. He calls us to love the world, to love the creation because God made it. It's part of our showing love to him. He taught us to be generous and thankful. His famous special relationship with birds and animals is all part of his special relationship with the God who made them. People talk about the need for us to live in harmony within our environment, to live in harmony with others. And Francis would say, that's absolutely right. First thing is to try and live in harmony with God, and then everything else will flow from it. And affirm our faith in the God who created the universe, sustains the world, the God who loves us. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith.
We believe and trust in God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now, in union with Christ and in the power of the Spirit, let us pray to the Father. Please sit or kneel to our prayer.
Now let us thank God for all his good gifts to us, and let us pray for all those in need. After each section we will say, Lord, in your mercy, and you answer, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all farmers. We thank you for their hard work in providing us with food. We ask that you will bless them and their families. Help them to trust you and encourage them in times of difficulty and disappointment. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for beef and dairy farmers, for sheep and poultry farmers. May they care for their animals properly and treat them with respect, remembering that we are all part of your creation. Lord, in your mercy. We pray, Lord, for all those farmers in other countries far away, for those who do not have enough to eat themselves, while their produce is sold cheaply in our shops. We pray for a more just world, and that we may be willing to share the good things you give us. Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for drought or famine, where the crops don't grow or where they are destroyed by storm because the country is at war. We pray that we may be generous in our help for those in need, Lord, in your mercy. We pray for people who work in quarries and mines at sea, on oil and gas rigs, in the forest, and for all who work in hard and dangerous places to bring us what we need. Watch over them and keep them safe, Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all who work in offices, shops and transport to bring our food to us. We pray for our town. May we learn to live together and remember that we all need each other. We remember those who are known to us who are sick or sad or in special need, especially those whose names are on our prayer list. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, your will is so full of glory and beauty. Thank you for our coast, for the hills and the fields, the gardens and the woods. Help us to work with you to look after your creation, giving us food, homes, work, and times of joy together. Bless us and help us be aware of your love for us every day, Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Now, if there are any people who've got harvest gifts, if you'd like to take them up by the organ, along there, just place them along the altar rail and then go down through that door and back down that side. Have we got any other harvest gifts? Yes, some have already come. As we bring to God this offering, these harvest offerings, as we reflect on our world, as we reflect on what we have eaten and will eat today, if you wish, please join with me and say, yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Please stand. Self-control. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
blessed be God forever. Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this bread for, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this wine for, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God. We're going to use a different Eucharistic prayer this week. So just remember there's a little response right at the end. Please stand. The Lord is here. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time, you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You give us breath and speech, that with angels and archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to speak your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and light, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord, as a mother tenderly gathers her children. You embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, be the living bread in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave him thanks. He broke it, gave it to them, saying, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance of me. Great is a mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Father, we confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ, and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity, guard her faith, and preserve her in peace. And bring us at the last with Francis and all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendor which you have created us through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven. we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Sit or kneel to the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. We break this bread to share the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, Christ. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called his son. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. These elements not just for myself, but for all those who would receive them but are unable to do so, the sharing of this service online. Body and blood. Body and blood. Body leads the lambs to pasture and the deer to water, who multiply loaves and fishes and change water into wine. Lead us, feed us, multiply us, and change us, reflect the glory of our Creator through all eternity. The blessing of God Almighty,